That's just the most wonderful sound. I guess I'm gonna play as Bucky first, right? Troopers begin their invasion of the planet Warren, Bucky's home planet.
What, the slithering pack of belch bums? Look at them, mateys! How can they do such a thing? Nothing in the universe will be safe from those wart brain toads. Attention all hands, battle stations. Let's croak some toadies!
By the actual actors, too. I mean, this was pretty much built on the same engine as every single one of Konami's beat-em-ups. As you can see. This never got a console port. I'm so sad. I mean, not that it matters, obviously, but, the music kind of reminds me of, Metal Slug, almost. I wonder if it was the same person. And there is no difference to playing as any of the characters. Oh, watch this! You break the fucking Konami boss wide open. And all of these characters were bosses in the NES game as well.
What did you do to my people, Alnigator?
That's a laugh.
Captain Bucko's fixing to fry your scales, Negator. Better talk.
Oh, it's hard as shit, but it's worth it. Konami handled this game really fucking well, both the arcade game and the NES game, because the NES game actually uses music from the show. So, if you played the NES game, you could actually recognize music from, I mean, both the show and the NES game. So, like, this is the Red Planet.
Ugh.
Alright. Now I gotta switch to my boy Blinky. And like I mentioned in my, my Let's Play of Bucky O'Hare, this is the giant fuck-off backpack he was wearing. You can't see it in the NES sprite, but Blinky is like this crazy combat android, and his backpack has like every fucking weapon ever. I still have my Blinky toy somewhere. I lost the majority of my Bucky O'Hare figures when my house burned down. But it was one of those things where, like, I just so happened to take my Blinky toy with me to my mom's that when I went home that one managed to survive. And there's no story difference for playing as any of the characters. So after I play through each character at least once, I'm probably going to go back to Blinky. Look at that walk! Coming to fuck your bitch! This is what I mean, when you have a ranged weapon, you just like bust the fucking game wide open.
Take a look out there! That's a climate converter! Oh no, they're forcing the slaves to build one here too!
They've gone too far. No fly-sucking, slimy, croaking piece of sludge toad is taking over Planet Punk! Matey, here's what we gotta do, and we gotta do it fast!
Not potato chips. I should get the Ninja Turtles games, but I really would rather just play the NES versions, because that's the one I'm more familiar with. Like, I know that's what everybody, like, wants you to get, but... They would probably make a mobile game. And that's the unfortunate... Play Deadeye, get him out of the way. That's okay, I didn't want to be Deadeye anyway. Now this is what makes me mad, is that Jenny uses a gun. And that doesn't make any fucking sense because Jenny has psychic powers. I don't even think her toy came with a gun. And she even uses her bomb from her psychic power, which, like... I think they just gave her a gun so that they could have, like, one shot hitbox, if that makes sense. If I'm saying that right, so that all the sprites would be basically the same.
Signal.
Good work, Jenny. What have we got?
I feel this signal coming from the asteroid belt.
And this was a level that was, like, made to eat your quarters until you remember that everyone's gotta hover if you jump. Because you do have to do some actual platforming here. Oh, goodbye. Well, I think just for Rabbit's sake, I should play as Bucky. I can't believe Jenny is fucking dead. You fucking mutant frosted flakes, man. Oh. Okay. Fucking hippies. That's not anything I really remember from the show, but at the same time, I haven't seen the show in over 20 years. Like, this show got one of those, one of those, like, bootleg print DVDs where it's just some guy in his basement making them. Like, I got the Earthworm... What's it? Shout Factory, I think it was. Like, I got the Earthworm Jim one. But... thanks, Godmouse. As you can see, this is where Battletoads and Double Dragon starts. I've beaten the SNES one because the Super Nintendo one is easier.
Most humble androids please to navigate, Captain O'Hare, but too late. What the toads have done, I cannot bear to speak of it. Planet Rat must have been overthrown.
No, it's not too late. Rodent, the old mouse, is still alive somewhere on the Planet Rat.
2020, Year of the Rat. I think the only reason those dinosaur enemies exist is to be like, oh yeah, there is technically a melee attack, isn't there? The next time I play some arcade games, I need to start keeping track of how much money it takes me to beat. I used to do that whenever I'd play Metal Slug. I think my record was I beat Metal Slug 3 only spending like $2 once. Not old Jenkins and his lawnmower. Damn it. Boo. Look at the fucking temple, it just has a door. Step on that fucking spider.
Bucky O'Hare, we are much obliged. You have saved our planet and our tribes.
Yes, Rodent, but there are many planets out there that have been polluted.
There is only one way to restore the planets. Send back the planetary life force stored in the Toad Star to the surface of each.
What's the planetary life force?
Banana oil! Them lousy toads just keep coming, Captain! What are we gonna
Banana oil! What if we just took the planet's life force and pushed it somewhere else? The inner mechanisms of the Toad Star are an enigma. Alright, big finish with my boy. I cannot deny myself what I crave.
Ew.
Question, is this technically a beat-em-up? I would consider it one. It is made on the Konami engine. Oh my god. The last time I played this was like a couple years ago with Alex and Nick and Joe, and we like fucking wrecked this game. We did have this at like my local Chuck E. Cheese, but I never got that far.
Mission accomplished! Wards off a few dozen more of them fly-munching toadies! I'll atomize mammal mush and mangle their mammal bones!
Oh god! Yeah, this is one of those, it's one of those enemies where it's like, hope you brought friends, fucko. Thank you. Coming to fuck your bitch. Run, little toads! Oh, Christ. Oh, God! Oh, God! Infanticide? Or are they clones, or what's going on there? You think they have a good break room here? They've got, like, uniforms. I've always wondered what it's like to be like a, you know, like a henchman, you know? Was it the Hitman games where it's like you can sit and listen to someone and be like, oh yeah, I just bought my little girl a birthday present, blah 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 blah. And then you can just fucking kill the dude. I wanna say it was the new Hitman. See, it's amazing the kind of shit that, overlaps as far as nerd culture goes. Because, when I think of the Righteous Indignation, I think of Bucky O'Hare's ship. But for Nick, that's like a spell in Warcraft. This was the only villain who didn't make it to the NES game. Yeah. The final boss of the NES game was the Air Marshal. This was the, like, the bad guy's computer network. And, in the final episodes of the show, he, like, made himself a body. But the entirety of the NES game is based on, like, two of the episodes, I think. Because there was, like, there was, like, a two-part episode where the crew got kidnapped and brainwashed. Hope you got quarters, fucker. But where's the kaboom? Oh. Those fucking hippie mice again. Thank you.
troopers begin their invasion of the planet Quarren, Bucky's home planet.
Oh boy. And there you have it. Oh my god! I'm fucking tired! Oh. Let me leave you with one thing.
Crush my cock with a rock, I must. Maximum pain I must endure. Okay, here we go.